Hey, this is Kip, and in this video, we're going to continue the OnAir Company series. This is part two, and in this part, we're going to look at how to use the Logistics Center, which is a place where you can find more jobs. You can pick from hundreds of jobs. These are separate from the mission-type jobs that we looked at in part one. And also, we're going to cover how to use AI pilots. And the AI or NPC pilots actually apply to all three game worlds. So that includes Cumulus and Stratus, as well as Thunder. Though the main difference is that on Thunder, you cannot have an AI pilot do the actual pilot flying role. They can only be co-pilots or flight attendants, but you do need them in certain situations on Thunder as well. The first thing that we're going to do is go to the employee list just by hitting this big employee button on the dashboard. You can also get to this section by going up to the top menus under My Company. So here in the list, you can see we just have ourselves. This is just me. This is my avatar, basically. It's kind of the employee that represents me as a human pilot. We can see our position is currently at X-ray 06, which is Arcadia, where we left off in Florida. Now I'm going to go to the global job market by hitting this button here. And this will show us a list of all of the AI or NPC employees that are available to be hired. So this includes pilots and co-pilots, flight attendants, and mechanics. In this video, we're going to focus on hiring and using the pilot NPCs. If you're on the Cumulus or Stratus servers, then you can actually use an NPC pilot to accept and fly a job completely without you even loading your simulator. But if you happen to be on the Thunder server, remember that the pilot flying role can only be done by an actual human. In all three worlds, you will still need co-pilots, flight attendants, and mechanics, depending on your situation. If you're flying a larger plane, there'll be a requirement for a certain number of co-pilots, one or more, and also mattering how many passengers you're taking, there may be a requirement to also hire and bring flight attendants as well. And lastly, mechanics are employees that you would hire to work at a workshop at an FBO if you choose to build one of those. And not only will they be able to perform maintenance and inspections on planes that you lease and own, but you'll also be able to offer those services to other players in OnAir Company on the same world. So you can earn credits by offering those services. What I'm going to do now is browse this list of pilots and co-pilots, and I'm going to find a pilot so I can demonstrate how to use them on Cumulus and Stratus to fly a job for us. So in this list, you'll see their per week rate, per hour, and wages. The C column stands for certifications, and that's how many different types of planes they're able to fly. A low punctuality rating will make it more likely that there are delays with the flight when this pilot is flying. So there'll be either departure or arrival delays, so it'll take longer for them to do the flight than normal. And then stress resistance, the lower this rating is, the more likely the pilot is to make errors while flying. So they could cause more stress or more engine damage, or even have to divert to an airport for an emergency situation. All right, so I'm just going to pick kind of a random pilot here. This guy, Jürgen, says he has 10 certifications, so I'm just going to hit the evaluate button. And this will bring us over to his page of details. We can see his salary or hourly rates. We can see all of his certifications down here in the bottom left. And then on the right side, we have two options on how to hire him. You can either choose between making them a contractor, so they'll kind of be a perpetual employee for you until you cancel the contract, or you can hire them as a freelancer for 1 to 3 days, but no longer than 3 days. You can see that the hourly and weekly rates are different depending on which option you choose. So I would just pick based on how long you want the employee to work for you. If you're just doing a couple flights and you may forget to end their contract when you're not using them, I would go for the freelancer because after those 1, 2, or 3 days are completed, they'll be off your payroll. Whereas if you left them on a contract and forgot about them, you would be paying them, you know, in this case, 1,380 credits every week, even if you're not using them. So because I plan on using them for a bit, I'm going to go ahead and use the contract. All you do is type in the airport name you want them to start at. So I'll put in Arcadia and then click on sign contract. Now let's go back to our employees list. So I'm going to go up to the top left under My Company and then click employees. And now we can see that Jürgen is part of our employees list right next to us. If you hover over this little icon here, it'll show you what it means. In this case, it just says idling, which means he's just waiting. He's able to be used right now and do some flights for us. So let's do that. Now, the first thing we need to do is get a plane for him to fly. If I click the airplane shortcut in the top, remember we only have our Cessna 172 Skyhawk that I rented and flew for one flight in the first part of this video series. So he has a lot of certifications. You know, Jürgen isn't just a single engine piston pilot. He's capable of flying 10 different plane types. So even though we can only fly one right now, he can do a lot more than we can. So what I want to do is take advantage of that and find a plane that will bring in more money per job than the 172 that I can fly. So I'm going to go up to the world menu and then aircraft market. And we're going to find a plane that's bigger than the 172, but that we can still afford and that Jürgen can fly. First, I'm going to make sure that the checkbox at the top that says show affordable aircraft only is checked. And the simulator drop down here, I'm actually going to change this to all simulators. I don't have an intention of flying this plane myself. If I did, I would, of course, want to make sure that I'm only choosing a plane available in my sim. But because I'm going to only use this plane with the AI pilot, the simulator doesn't matter. He can fly every plane in OnAir Company, regardless of what simulator it may or may not be available on. I took a look at the details of a few planes, but I ended up picking this PA-44 Seminole. Up here, we can see the minimum airport size is 0, and it does not need a co-pilot. So I'm going to hit the green button here to find what's available to rent near me. So the airport size is important just because Arcadia is a size 1 airport. So I needed to make sure that if it's flying out of and into Arcadia as a home base, that we don't pick a plane that requires an airport size greater than 1. So this one was a 0, so it can fly out of any airport. So I'll pick this one right here, 67 Delta. The engine condition is not very good, but actually most of them here that are available for rent don't have good engine conditions. But this was around the price I was willing to spend. So this is 4,800 credits for the bond. That's the deposit, which we get back later. And then the dry rental price with no fuel, 480 credits per hour. So this is affordable for me. So we just hit the rent button down here to continue. And it'll bring up the seat configuration window again. So I'm going to go ahead and choose from this drop down here, the no seats preset. I want to maximize how much cargo we can take. And right now I've just been flying cargo missions, so it just kind of simplifies life for me. I'll only need to look at cargo missions and think about payload weight and not passenger count. We can see that the Seminole is now in our aircraft list page here, but it's at 2 Fox Alpha 6, so it's not where our pilot and our home base is. So to get it there, I can click this manage button and then click on ferry. This will let us pay to have the plane transported to any airport of our choice. And it's actually not that expensive. So I'll type in X-ray 06 for Arcadia and then click start ferry. And this little pop-up will come up giving us a summary of the cost. So we can see it'll be one leg. The total flight duration is 0.7 and the total travel duration is 1.2 hours. It shows us the time the plane will be available and then the cost, which is only 123 credits, which is very cheap. Once I hit OK, you can see that the status is now this purple little symbol here, and it says it's being ferried until a specific day and time. A more efficient way to do this would have been to find the plane first and rent it, and then go and hire the pilot, because we can start the pilot at any airport. So the pilot and the plane would have been at the exact same location right away. But in this case, I have our pilot at our home base, where we already have the Skyhawk, and I'm just ferrying the PA-44 to our home base as well. In the meantime, I'll just have our pilot fly the 172 that we already have. Remember, you can always return to the aircraft list with this little shortcut at the top center. The quickest way to find a job based around a specific plane is over here on the right side. So in the row for the 172 Skyhawk, I can just click this second little button right here that says find jobs at the current airport. In part one, we saw a similar looking screen like this that was the pending jobs list, but now we're on this tab right here called the Logistics Center. And this is where we can search from thousands and thousands of jobs to find one that works for us. Because I use the shortcut from the aircraft menu, it's automatically set our departure airport and it's chosen our current plane from this filter preset dropdown. This dropdown, when you change it, it will automatically change the total weight and the passenger filters for your specific plane's configuration. Then over here on the right, there are a bunch of checkboxes, so you can do things like exclude airports without lights. And what I'm going to do is use this checkbox here that says exclude human-only jobs, because I want to find jobs that can be flown by our AI pilot. So then I'll check that, and then I'll click on Query Logistics Center again, and that'll do a new search with my new filters applied. All right, so now we've narrowed it down to 33 possible jobs. You can see that none of these jobs have passengers in the column there that says packs. And all of these little icons, these little green boxes, these signify that every one of these is a cargo job, because that's all we can do right now, mainly because I configured this plane to have no seats. You can sort by any of the columns here. So if you want to sort by the highest paying job, just click pay a couple times and the highest paying job will be sorted to the top. You can click any of the rows to automatically move and pan the map to show you where the job is going to. So in these cases, these are one leg jobs, but some of them will have multiple destinations where you need to take cargo or passengers. Another way to do this is by using the map on the right side. If you want to go in a specific direction, for example, say I want to go to the north as my destination, I can start clicking on the little icons for these destination airports, and it'll automatically filter the list on the left for jobs going to this specific airport. These all just have one job going to them, but sometimes you'll get see two or three jobs going to the same airport and you can stack them up. Then you can just click the show all button over here to return to the entire list of 33 jobs in this case. Another column I sort by often is this second to last one right here. And it says pay per 1,000 pounds per nautical mile. So if you sort by this, it may help you find some jobs that will pay the same as other jobs, but with less distance traveled or carrying less weight with you. All right, so I'm gonna go scroll down here and just find a random job to take. This one looks good. It's for 2,000 credits. And the distance says 62 nautical miles and 801 pounds of cargo. So first what I'm gonna do, you can just hit the take button, but I'm gonna hit this little plus first to look at the details. And it's just one leg, so all I have to do is fly to one airport. This little F button right here, this lets you check the FBO services available at the destination you're flying to. This can be important just to make sure that there's fuel available to refuel at this airport so you can have a return trip. I've actually stranded myself by going somewhere where they actually didn't have any fuel available. So you can actually see at our destination, jet fuel is not available. Luckily, we don't need jet fuel. We just need 100 low lead. So that's available. So we'll be good for our return trip. Now all I have to do is click the take button right here, and that will accept the job. To see a list of all our pending jobs, we can use the global shortcut way up here at the top, this little button that says pending jobs. And once that loads, you can see the first one is the one we saw at the end of the last video, which is our mission. That's a level 2 mission. But the one under it is the job we just accepted from the logistics center. And just like before, all we have to do is click on the little plane button here to start the flight. And we'll choose the only plane we have available still, which is the 172. So this will take us to the flight preparation screen, which we saw in the last video. On the top left here, we have our cargo list. This is all the cargo that's available to take from our home base. And you can see this one right here is not checked. This one called number one cargo delivery is actually for the mission. We're not doing that. We're doing the job that we just picked up. So this was checked by default for us. That's one of the benefits from using the pending jobs page and hitting that little flight button. So it'll automatically check the correct cargo. But down here, I can see that we're overweight by 2 pounds. So this doesn't feel good to do, but I'm just gonna decrease our fuel with a little down arrow up here in the top center. And it's gonna tell us that we're gonna dump a little bit of fuel and we won't be able to get that fuel back. So that's fine with me. I just don't wanna have the plane overweight. Now I'm just gonna click the validate fuel and payload button at the bottom to let the loading process go on. Once that's completed in the bottom right, we'll see this fly now button is available. And this is what we'll hit if we want to fly with our human pilot right now. If I use the drop down in the top right to change to our AI pilot, you'll see that we get this new button, start AI flight. But what's interesting is that there are two options, even though we've selected the AI pilot. The first option says fly in sim now, and what we actually can do is fly as if we are Jürgen. So we could fly planes that he's certified for that we are not. Or the other option is to start the AI flight. And that's what we're gonna do here. I'm gonna click start AI flight. And what happened to me was I actually got an error message, and it was because I didn't have enough range, enough fuel to make my alternate airport. So what I had to do is actually go back and find another job. This is something that happens every now and then. One way you could avoid this is by being a little more conservative with how much payload you take. So I'm loading 801 pounds. So in the future, I might want to limit my payload to say 650 or 700 pounds and see how that works. Another thing I could do is just take half of the payload using the sliders in the top left, but I don't want to deal with that. So what I'm going to do is just go back and quickly, and I'll fast forward this part, we'll quickly go back and find a different job that's going to work. So in this case, yeah, I can't take the entire payload. So I'm going to go back to my pending jobs list. And the first thing I'm going to do is abandon this job. So I'm just going to hit abandon, and there shouldn't be any penalties applied because we just accepted it. So I'll say okay to that. And now I'm just going to go back to the logistics center and find a new job. All right, so here we are back on the preparation screen. And this time I took a little under 600 pounds for my payload instead of 800. So this is something you'll get used to with whatever plane you're flying. You'll kind of figure out the best payload for you to take over certain distances. And so I'm just going to go ahead and load that again and hit the payload load button, and we'll wait for that to load up. All right, now I'm just going to change the pilot from me back over to Jürgen. And once again, we see the two options, fly in sim now or start AI flight. And because I don't want to fly it as a human, I'll click the start AI flight button instead. All right, we have no errors this time. And what it does is it says starting flight, and now it's taken us over to a screen we haven't seen before. This is called the live operations map. So this is going to show us globally where our planes and our employees are. So if I zoom in here, this is our home base at Arcadia. And this is one of the few places you actually see your avatars. So right here, this green plane right there is actually the Piper Seminole that's being ferried here. So you can see that little purple icon next to it. And then this is my avatar. I'm awaiting orders. But down here, we can see Jürgen and we can see the Skyhawk. So it says his status that they're loading the cargo right now. So once that's done, he'll be departing. And it shows all sorts of information like his ETA, what phase of flight he's in. And we can actually watch him in real time fly on this moving map. So now we have an AI employee doing flights for us. He's going to get his pay, but the remainder of that money is going to go straight into our company's bank. So you can see how as you get more money, you can hire more and more AI pilots and then have them flying routes all the time. The problem right now is that once Jürgen gets to his destination, he's just going to sit there idling on the ground doing nothing. And that's why in the next part, part three, we're going to look at a feature called work orders. And this is going to allow us to string together a bunch of different jobs and basically give him an entire day's worth of work to do at once. And once we start that work order, he'll fly the entire route, delivering all of the cargo we've set up for him in advance. So it'll be a much more efficient use of his time and ours. I hope you're enjoying OnAir Company so far, and I'll see you in part three.